Let's have a closer look at the AE 0.1cc diesel engine. The instruction manual included is general for all engines in the series. Basic instructions on use and fuels, and suggested propellers. Didn't even include the 0.2 and 0.1. This looks like an addition for this specific engine, the 0.1, for the propeller size, the Cox 3x1.25. This is the original Venturi needle valve. I had trouble trying to get the engine to run with this and ended up using something else. Part of the problem seemed to be that the needle valve has very little taper and also doesn't fit the metering orifice properly. The threads on this are also very loose. Every time you touched it, it would change, and I never had any luck with it. The little Cox 3-inch propeller. The engine has a black anodized aluminum crankcase, a tank mount in the back, spring starter in the front. Cooling fins on the cylinder are quite large, as we'll see later. Four bolts in the back hold the tank on, and there are three cylinder bolts. We'll take off the spring starter to start. You can see the reduced section on the nose for the spring starter. That is the Venturi assembly needle valve that I installed. It's secured with a set screw on the left side of the engine. This is actually a Super Tiger idle jet assembly from a very old engine. I think it's from the late 50s, early 60s. Itself, and there is a thin paper gasket in the groove. There's also a paper gasket on the crankcase between the crankcase and the tank. For such a small engine, being a diesel, it does have a large crank pin and substantial connecting rod. Cooling fins just lift off the top, and we can see that the cylinder itself is much smaller underneath. Cooling fins press the cylinder against the lower set of cooling fins, which also contains the transfer passages to the cylinder. There's a paper gasket there. Looks like mine might be damaged. piston in the top of the cylinder. Radial exhaust porting, typical of diesels. And here we see the tiny piston. The piston diameter is about 5 millimeters. Here I have congealed castor on the top of the piston from not cleaning it. On these tiny engines, it's a good idea to clean them after you're done so that you don't have that sort of problem. They're delicate and the combustion chambers are very, very tiny. The wrist pin is feels like it's pressed into the connecting rod. I'll get a closer look at it when I take it apart to measure it later. You can see the intake passage in the crankcase here. The prop driver fits on a spline on the crankshaft. In the crankcase, there is a oil groove in the crankshaft bore. It's typical, and otherwise, it's just a standard crankcase. For such a small engine, there is a large, thick crank web and a fairly substantial crank pin, and that's the last part of the engine. Stay tuned for some measurements and a CAD model in the near future. Thanks, and if you like my engine videos, subscribe and for more.